Sent it out and sent it to Max Martin, And yeah, he's pretty cool, right? So I got together, I talked to him on the phone, and he goes, "Man, this song is a smash. Come to Stockholm." I said, "Okay." And I flew out to Stockholm, and he and I sat in the studio, and you guys never heard of the recording, but the original recording was me and Max Martin for this song right here. And it's called "In Love With a Girl."
So many people gonna say that they want you, try to get you thinking they really care. There ain't nothing like the warmth of the one who is put in the time, and you know it's gonna be there. Back in your arms, you know someone crossed it. When I'm out, put you down to your knee. Take the pain of protecting your name from the crush to the king, to the high wire. I'm in love with a girl and must be bad. Stay upon the woman, swear I met her. In sweet time, now it's better. The someone understands, and she knows how to treat it better, right? To give me that feeling every night. Want some big love and I want to fight. Now someone understand me.
So free, you know what I mean? Something to get you.
drones. This neighborhood crawls. I'm looking at the crowd, you're staring at your phones. The human coastline here is starting to disappear. Even once a year, I think it's in my heart. Cigarettes and alcohol, I can't let it go. No, I can't see straight. I got obligations when you did me.
With a guy from Gothenburg, named Johan Carlson. He was in Max Martin's camp, and it goes like this.
Back in your house, back in your home, goodbye to the innocence I see.
be the first to say I can't take it anymore. In that over the last few years, my personal hero, my musical idol, Billy Joel, has called us and invited us to come out and play so many shows with him over the course of the last 2 years. And it's been a dream come true for me. And I know that the guys here also were huge fans, and we've all been kind of gushing about the gig, you know? But something that I was a little bit thrown off of was, you know, every night that he plays, of course, we're huge fans, so we're standing on the side of the stage watching Billy play, you know? And so he would go through his song list, And every once in a while, when he gets to a song, he stops the show, like I'm doing right now. And he tells us what he doesn't like about the song he's about to play. Which is a little weird for me to watch as a fan, because he's going, here's what doesn't make sense about this song, and this was pretty stupid right here, and this was really dumb, this didn't make any sense. And I'm, of course, at the side of the stage going, no, Billy, no, don't do it. So anyway, this next song, the lyrics are pretty ridiculous. I just want to let you know that. I wouldn't write this song ever again, but I'm happy I wrote it, because it's a lot of fun to play and sing, and that's really all that matters. Just don't listen to the lyrics. Michael Baker on the drums. So I put an album out this past year. I want to say about 8 months ago. Might have been 10, could have been 12. I don't remember. But I was talking to some people in the music business, right? Because there's music, and then there's business, and then there's the music business, and none of them really make sense together. So I said to my friend in the business, I said, hey, I just finished my album. They said, oh, that's great. What are you gonna call it? I said, well, I wrote a song on the album, and it's one of my favorites, and I like the title of the song, so I'm thinking about naming the album after the song. I said, okay, well, what is the song? And I said, well, it's called Something Worth Saving. Thank you for that. Well, this person didn't react quite so friendly. And they said, okay, that's great. About that. I said, what about that? They said, well, you know what critics are, right? I said, yeah. They said, well, I'll give you an example. So let's say, critic doesn't like your album, and you've named the album Something Worth Saving. What do you think a critic might call your album? I said, I don't know. They said, maybe like something worth throwing in the garbage? I said, I hadn't really thought about it like that. Well, they said, well, you're not a critic. I said, well, I don't care about the fucking critics. So they said, well, good luck. So anyway, I wrote this album. This is the song called Something Worth Saving. Which if you're a critic out there, you very well may think is worth something throwing in the garbage. It was like this. Thank you so much. How many of you were here last time you played up? Thank you guys so much for coming back and for continuing to support us. We appreciate it. It makes it, it changes our lives, so we really appreciate that. Thank you for coming back. And all you new people, all you first timers, thanks for coming to give us a try. I hope you're loving it. And we're having a great time with where we're living. Thanks so much. Let's get it, fellas, shall we?
Rock and roll. I'm a rebel man. Pick a bottle to the other end. I'm a rebel man. Pick a bottle to the other end. I'm a
So I have a brother who is, he's a lot of things. And he went through a lot of phases, you know, when we were kids, and he's about 4 years older than me. And when I was about 12, 13, he wanted to be a boxer, you know, which I was excited about because maybe he could fight somebody else for a change, you know what I mean? Because he was a lot older than me. I was like, yeah, that's a great idea, man. Go, you know, we'll fight everybody else, you know, because I was tired. And so he gets really heavily into this boxing thing, you know. And I'm going around, I'm helping him out, you know. I'm like his corner masseuse kid, you know. I'm like, hey, gotta get him rock, you know. Mess him up. Which is, I was a pretty terrible boxing coach because I didn't know anything about fighting, you know. I was like, just don't die. So anyway, he's going to this boxing gym, and the boxing gym was in the basement of a steakhouse off the highway. This is a true story. So I didn't really have any interest in getting punched in the face for a living, but I would go to the boxing gym because it was fun to watch other people, you know, who were aggressive, get hurt. So anyway, I'm over there, and at night we'd go hang out there, me and my brother, and the trainer's son. The trainer's son was a drummer. We'd hang out, we'd play music late at night, you know. And the trainer comes downstairs one night, and he says, hey, I heard you singing. And I want you to listen to these albums. And he gives me a couple albums. He gave me a Ray Charles record, and he gave me a Sam Cooke record. And he said, I want you to take these home, and I want you to listen to these. And I'd never listened to that, you know, those albums before. I said, okay, you know, I'll do that because I don't want you to beat the shit out of me. So I did. And anyway, I fell in love with some of the songs. I'm going to play for you one of the songs that I just fell in love with, became one of my favorite songs of all time. This song goes out to anybody out there who's got someone in their life they could call no matter what happens, be there anytime you need them, talk you through anything you need them to talk you through. And, you know, a soldier for you. Yeah.
somebody told me, if I'm not careful, well, this one don't grow. I got my mental, and this one turn on me. If you show me, I'm so mystified. She bought the last train last night. Just enough to rotate me, see you next time. See you tomorrow.
This next song was on a record that in the music industry doesn't count as a record. This was an album made after my second album, but it's not called my third album. They call it a bridge record. That means you can make any album you want, but it doesn't count. Which is okay with me, because I got to make the record I wanted to make. Cool? So I had a similar conversation with my brother Joey, who's a funny man. And I said, Joe, I'm making a bridge record. He goes, what the hell's that? I said, it's a record that doesn't count as a record. He said, well, good luck. He said, what are you gonna call it? I said, I'm gonna call it Free. Joyce, so you're the three people who bought that record. I said, I'm gonna call it free. And he goes, yeah, free for $20. I said, okay. So I'm gonna play you one of my favorite songs off of this record, off of Free for $20. So we have one more song left for you guys. I wish we could stay longer, man.
So